Hey everyone, it's Professor Gull here. We're going to finish up Golvellius today. I'm actually not going to play all the way through the game itself, but we'll get far enough to at least push everybody in the right direction. From the last episode, I just finished off Bacular, as you just saw there. I obtained his crystal. You need to get all the crystals, of course, to finish the game. But in the meantime, I need to regain some money so I can buy something. Like this game is, it's always about grinding and getting money. And of course, using tips and tricks to get what you want. I'm just gonna sit here and kill a few snakes. I'm in the graveyard. And soon after this, I'll be headed south to the swamp, which you guys will see here shortly. And we'll start getting some interesting items. Yes, please. Thanks, Rainer. I did feedback you. Thank you very much. So after doing that, you can go south. Through the graveyard. That piece of wall will open up. Yeah, straight down the path. And what they mean by that is literally straight down. It's funny, because some of the fairies do give you very good hints. Others are... really? And potato bugs. Every life potion you get your hands on. Well, looks like I'm running out of money again. Now, as the game progresses, everything gets more and more expensive. The creatures, they just keep coming. Ring of Invisibility. Ring of okay, remember that. Oh, what the heck? Is that? Oh, frogs! Yeah, I hate to say it, but frogs are probably one of the worst things I had to fight in this one. So obviously I went back north for a second. Get some more money. Why show you guys grinding getting money? South so we can find the ring of invisibility. So this is one of those special screens. I don't know if I'll be able to do it. But you're supposed to kill a certain number of these guys in a row, and a cave will open. 17. Unfortunately, they do a lot of damage. It's not 17. Anybody keeping track? I know that's a spot where you have to kill a bunch. Thanks for the health, Rander. So, I did promise another thing. I said I promised to find the aqua boots for you guys. That's kind of an intense thing to try to find. And it's definitely an expensive thing to find, too. Let me kind of head towards the direction you need to go for those. Follow along with me here. It's funny because this is one of the hardest things to find in the game. aqua shoes are. You gotta hit this tree. This tree. Yep. Open that cave. Ignore the tree, just that one. And here are the aqua shoes. Not enough money. Ugh. It's all your fault, Frog. Why don't you play the game? I'm tired of this. You do it. Oh, you brought friends. So there's the ring of invincibility, not invisibility. You get to that in the swamp. Here I am in the swamp. You'll figure out where I am when I leave here. It's kind of a maze. This is nowhere near the aqua boots, but you need to have the aqua boots to get the ring. Every dungeon's different. We've gone through some of the horizontal ones, like this one, and some of the vertical ones. There is a bad guy at the end of this one. Warusa. I can never remember. It's one of the two of them. I suppose we'll find out when we get there. And if once again, if you're curious to know what each of the bad guys looks like, I did display it in the manual reading, so you can find that video, as well as the previous ones to this one, to help you through this wonderful game. Fire-breathing snake. Ow. About what to strike to find your way forward. And sometimes what you hit will trap you. Always try to take the high road, by the way. That was all skill. Wilson's got fire too. Oh. Curving fire. That's annoying. Ah, there's a secret for you. Like you would have known how to destroy all those blocks, right? Because those don't break, but the ones at the bottom do. Most of the dungeons are full of weird stuff like that, so it becomes trial and error, which can be very bad and annoying. Can't get up there, so that doesn't do anything. I'm probably getting pretty close to the end, though. Give you health after a while after you kill him. So that way you're powered up when you get to the end guy, which I think I'm right there. Oh, Phosphus. Oh, good lord. This is one of the more difficult bosses. But, if you watch the pattern, back and forth is all she moves. And launches those spheres, which shatter. I've got some healing leaves on me, so if you watch my power disappear and come back, that's why. Die already. This is almost worse than frogs. I will have to say, I hate frogs the most. They're probably the worst enemy in this game. So annoying. Yeah. And that's the death of the Swamp King, or Queen, if you like. But see, frogs. I got problems with frogs. So like I said, once you get the Aqua Boots, I'm in the desert area again. You can walk across everything, you bring invincibility, you can bash rocks, just like that. I thought I'd show you another hidden cave. Another bad guy to kill. Like I said, that was Phosphus, so this one must be Waruso. Oh, see what happened there? Went the wrong direction. But you can go right back. Learning curve. I don't have any of these dungeons memorized by heart. I'm going back to playing this game after a while. I don't necessarily remember everything. You do want to kind of keep yourself towards the top of the screen. I know you're going to get hit a lot, but it gives you more time to react. Like, which way should I go here? I pick this way. Is it wise? Well, both ways would have gotten you out, but how was I supposed to know? That gave me all my health back. All these bats and health make the game any easier? It makes it a little bit easier. I mean, they weren't trying to really make it impossibly hard. Because you got a lot of puzzles. You got a lot of bad guys to fight. Bad guys do lots of damage to you, especially the bosses. I don't know, I'd like to know some of your opinions. Anybody else who's played this game? Let me know. You think it was too hard? Too easy? Just right? Good for a starter. This game was Sega's answer to that other game on the Nintendo. So you have two of them you have to fight. And all they do is they run back and forth. They try to run you over. Each one has its own set of hit points. Makes it really hard to hit both of them. You're trying to go after one and the other one comes after you. And they do quite a bit of damage to you, actually. Green one. Purple one gives you back half, green one gives you back a quarter. Thank goodness. Die already. How terrible would it be if I played this game, recorded this point, and watched me die? Feel the intensity. Yes! Oh, that was close. Thank God after you kill the bad guy, you get all your health back. He was almost as bad as those frogs, so. But those frogs, they're gonna pay now. Die, frogs! Just keep coming! Thank you. Now you're all alone, frog. It's right there, I bought the shield. The shield's better than the other shield. This one will stop arrows and axes. And that's caused my music to change. Place is north of where you get the aqua boots. Closer to the end of the game. There's a little interesting glitches here and there, like moving screen to screen and then ending up in foliage like that. So the shield I just bought is called Remedial Shield. Just to let you know. But I still need to get the Legendary Sword. That's the last thing you need to get. Once you obtain that, which is located here, in this area, then you have all the weapons. Those little ninjas are fast. Mia leaf, that one would give you half your life back.
So you did teach me some valuable lessons. One thing I learned, this is from that old biddy and the old lady, so I know where to keep my money now. The Bibles. That totally makes sense. Let's see, I got some of that, yeah, there, and one of these things. I don't know what that is, but that's going in there. Throw that in there. Now I know how to save money.
So that's Golvellius, guys. That's all I'm going to do today. The rest of it is for you to explore. And you know what? Just remember, frogs suck. This is Professor Gull. So thank you for joining for Golvellius Valley of Doom and my compile. I hope you enjoyed it. Please remember, no frogs were actually harmed in the making of this, but balloons were definitely destroyed. Thanks everyone. Like and subscribe, and we'll see you later.